What to do, where to go, what's happening and when. The spotlight's on fun and excitement all this week from the Lehigh Valley and beyond. So check out your calendar and let's go.
Hello, folks. Welcome to Let's Go. I'm Grover Silcox, your guide to the fun, the fantastic, and the fantabulous. On this episode, we're going to take you to the historic Sayre Mansion, now a bed and breakfast in Bethlehem, PA. Then we're off for a tasty yo-roll in Allentown. But first, we are going to Langhorne, Pennsylvania, home to the other Grover at Sesame Place, the only theme park in America based entirely on Sesame Street and the Muppets.
Hi, Grover.
Sesame Place is a place here in Langhorne, Pennsylvania, and we are a park geared for just all of Sesame Street. Kids 2 to 5 is kind of our target range, and we're the only theme park based on Sesame Street in the United States. Sesame Place is about family fun, and we're proud that a lot of our coasters and all of our attractions are very family friendly, and they're going to be memories that last a lifetime. Once you get to the park is divided up into different realms. So you'll have Cookie Monster Land, Elmo's World, the neighborhood, like the set that you'll remember on Sesame Street. Dine With Me is a core piece of Sesame Place. That's one of the big features in our park is our Dine With Elmo and Dine With the characters. And you'll see that goes on numerous times throughout the day. Water in our park is about 40% of our overall attraction. So this time of year is big and it's popular out here. Count Splash Castle is a water fortress, and it dumps a big bucket of water on you and cools you off. It's a great place for the kids to be able to just run around and play and stay cool. Our yellow rubber ducky is an icon here. Sky Splash is one of our biggest water slides in the park where all the family can get in one tube together and go down and enjoy it as a family. We have Vapor Trail, which is our first steel roller coaster. And some of our roller coasters, it's the very first ride they're ever going to go on. These roller coasters are a big deal.
For my grandson, he had never been on one and he did very well.
We also have Oscar's Wacky Taxi, which is our newest wooden steel hybrid roller coaster.
We went on the new roller coaster in the Grover ride, and it was so much fun.
Yeah, I thought it was awesome because how it went fast when you went down the little hill.
It's special, and that's what it's about here at Sesame Place, is having these great connections where kids will remember being able to go up and give Elmo a hug or Abby a big kiss on the nose, and it's having those personal one-on-one connections that we're all about at Sesame Place.
We like it. We having a ball. Y'all having fun?
Yeah.
We having fun. I love it.
Sesame Place is a place that you definitely want to make sure you come to if you have those kids between 2 and 5. It's a place that a lot of us have grown up with and brought our family to. We want to make sure that you have that same experience because this is where memories are made, and we want you to come out and enjoy the park as a family and leave with those fantastic memories.
And now we go from the fun and fanciful to the sublime and mysterious in Bangor, Pennsylvania, where a man and mythology await those looking for spiritual enlightenment among the giant stones of Columcille Megalith Park.
The way you think it is may not be the way it is at all.
In Bill Cohey's ode, The Stones of Columcille, Myth and Mystery, he welcomes visitors to come dance with the stones, to touch them and hear their songs, and to prepare to enter realms unknown.
Well, I've come to the conclusion that everything is sacred and nothing is sacred.
Bill created the Columcille Megalith Park on 20 acres in Bangor, Pennsylvania.
When I bought the house and the land here in 75, I was looking for kind of a space for reluctant saints and tired sinners. I knew a lot of them, having been one myself. Then came and sort of engaged in the land.
The inspiration for Columcille came to Bill from his experiences on the rugged isle of Iona, off the coast of Scotland. Here, a Celtic monk named Columcille, or Columba, found spiritual refuge among the island's prehistoric rocks in 563 AD.
And the first building we put up was the chapel out here. And I had a feeling, I had a vision of what it would be. It was six-sided. In fact, I drew the thing on the sand there by the ocean in Scotland. And came home, I said, I want each side 12 by 12. And there must be a boulder in the center of it to be grounded and centered.
For more than four decades, Bill Cohey, a former clergyman, has plumbed rocks as old as those on Iona from the foothills of the Blue Mountains and set them as mysterious monuments to dot the wooded hills of his beloved park. His circle of stones follow the Celtic calendar. The largest of Columcille's stones is Manannan, named for a sea god who protected sailors and, quote, the little people, unquote, of Ireland. In addition to the chapel, Bill and his friends built a bell tower dedicated to St. Columba's fellow monk, St. Oran.
And we built the St. Oran bell tower, which will never be finished, always be left open, as a reminder that it's always unfolding.
For Bill, these primordial stones hold an indefinable energy and the keys to mythologies as old as mankind, and that is what he offers visitors.
It's a beautiful, peaceful park, and I love to bring my dog. It's nice to have a little bit of open space here and enjoy it.
It's a place to get away from your everyday busy life, and you can just have some time to think, have some time to figure out who you are and what you need to do to make yourself better and make the world better.
In the closing lines of his ode, Bill writes, "May the spirit of oneness of all awaken your memory and connect you to the mysterious source. Enter through the infinity gate and journey at your own risk."
We say this is a space and a place to come and catch your breath. We get all these crazy stories. We get tired teachers, worn out doctors. As a typical story, I had a guy and his wife show up here, and I said, how was your hair about it? He said, well, we were down at Machu Picchu, and we were walking down there in Peru with a shaman, and we told him we were from Pennsylvania, and he said, you must go visit Columcille.
Columcille Megalith Park, where myth and mystery meet you at infinity's gate. Right here in South Bethlehem, overlooking the Hill-to-Hill Bridge, stands the stately mansion of Robert Sayre, one of the founders of the Lehigh Valley Railroad, Bethlehem Steel, and Lehigh University. Now it's an inn and bed and breakfast for anyone who wishes to take an elegant time out in the fashion of one of America's great industrialists.
The front porch is a very popular place. A lot of guests will have their breakfast outdoors or just sit and relax.
The Sayre Mansion is a small boutique hotel from a restored private home from 1858.
It's a wonderful place for people to gather to get a little cozy, rejuvenate, stay in a historic house.
23 guest rooms in two buildings, the main house and the carriage house. The mansion was originally owned by Robert Sayre, a very important individual in the Bethlehem area. He worked with Asa Packer for the establishment of the Lehigh Valley Railroad. He was president and founder of Bethlehem Iron Works, which became Bethlehem Steel, one of the founders with Asa Packer of Lehigh University, and a founder of St. Luke's Hospital. We very often say he had four wives and outlived them all, and he had 12 children. There was a servants' quarter on the third floor.
When it was restored and put into an inn, the library became a room, and the skylight is now the ceiling. In the original home, that was how the light came in through to the library. This is the room that we call the conservatory, which is what they would have called a glass house back in the day. And of course, this was just a skylight. This floor was not here. It really is our most popular room, but you really want to be here when it's a full moon at night. It's so pretty.
The rooms were built very large. His having a large family had a lot to do with that. The rooms have really distinctive architectural features, gold carved ceilings, all the original marble fireplaces. We have Robert Sayre's original wine cellar.
He okay. must have liked his Rieslings.
Yeah.
And then gin, 8 cases of partially filled gin with bitters, 6 gallons of whiskey, and 2,850 cigars.
Wow.
This is the Asa Packer room, our meeting room. And it's a great room for a meeting because there's not a lot of distractions looking out the windows. It's kind of cozy. It has this vaulted brick ceiling. We also use it for a rehearsal dinner or a small event, a private dinner party. We have 2 acres. We call it a downtown urban haven.
We're fortunate that we're located in Bethlehem downtown, which has 2 historic districts.
The Sayre Mansion, where weary travelers love a night away for a romantic getaway.
And now let's check out this week's Let's Go Family Friendly Finds.
At the Yo Fresh Yogurt Cafe in Allentown, you can get all your favorite traditional frozen yogurt desserts, but now they have something special, special to the region, a Yo Roll. That's right, I said Yo Roll, with all your favorite toppings topped off for a tip-top treat. Check it out.
Hi, welcome to Yo Fresh. How can I help you?
Yo Fresh Yogurt Cafe in Allentown is a frozen yogurt shop. Yo Fresh Yogurt actually caters to people who are looking for something different other than just plain ice cream. We sell 21 flavors of frozen yogurt, including non-dairy, no sugar added, gelatos, ice creams, sorbets on a rotating basis. On the self-serve side of the frozen yogurt, they absolutely create their entire own concoction.
Endless amount of different types of toppings we can choose from. We had about 100 toppings in the shop.
We are currently doing something new, innovative and delicious called Yo Rolls.
Our customer ordered a chocolate obsession with vanilla yogurt. What I'm gonna do first is grab the brownie and I'm gonna chop it up a little bit, just to make sure it's nice and fine. I'm gonna grab my yogurt, pour it, and throw it right on the pan. I'm gonna start condensing everything to the center so that it becomes easier to chop when the time comes, when the yogurt starts to freeze. Once it's all mixed up, I'm gonna start to spread it out, make sure it's distributed nice and evenly so that the rolls come out very nice. And while that sits there and freezes, I'm gonna grab my chocolate sauce. So now this is where I actually begin to roll it. Now we're gonna add the final touch, toasted marshmallow.
I think the Yo Roll is a really neat idea. It's a great presentation for the ice cream. I think it's great.
Yo Fresh is a great destination place for customers to come with their families for frozen treats. Just come on out and see for yourself.
I want to create the Let's Go Yo Roll of the month.
All right, let's go.
All right, well, our show's a little nutty, so let's how about some almonds?
Yes, sir.
We try to keep things fresh, so some fruit. We have a lot of colorful characters on our show, so how about some rainbow sprinkles?
Rainbow sprinkles on top.
And of course, we bring everything to a rousing climax. Let's get the whipped cream on there, maybe a little European flavor with some Ghirardelli caramel.
All right.
And of course, hit me with the cherry. As if you needed another reason to love Fridays, well, now there's Fresh Fridays Farmers Market with locally produced and grown foods and fare right in the heart of downtown Allentown. Take a look.
Today we are having Fresh Fridays. Fresh Fridays is a farmers market that takes place here on the Arts Walk every Friday from 12 to 4. So we try to create this little atmosphere down here where you can come have lunch, but you also can do some shopping and get some high quality produce. This year we have quite a few vendors. We have fresh vegetables, organic vegetables. The Rodeo Institute is here, and they basically are bringing vegetables and they're bringing organic meats. Be Well Blooms, they're doing cut flowers. Dreamland Farm, another small startup farm that's doing organic vegetables. We also have Holdafolk Homestead, which they cultivate mushrooms. And then we also have the Buttered Crumb. The Buttered Crumb is basically baked goods. Also, every Friday, we always highlight one of the local restaurants. One of the restaurants, because this week we have Green Mouth Cafe, which is in the Arts Walk also. They come out and they do a lunchtime special. Try to get people to come out of the offices and come sit outside and enjoy the beautiful weather and have lunch. And then we also have live music every Friday.
I'm thinking if we try then we can find some common ground, somewhere that's quiet, add another soul around. There's no need for words, I just need to listen now. Baby, hear me out.
Kind of want to invite everybody to the market, not just the downtown people that are working here, but all the people in the neighborhoods too. So we try to bring that from the outside and bring it into the city. Even if it is for only a 4-hour time frame during the week, people still enjoy the aspect of being able to go out and see what's available and also get to talk. Like all the people that are here selling it also are the people producing it. We're always talking to people that are customers and finding out, you know, what else would you rather see here? What else, how else can we make this better? And then we'll take their advice and we kind of go from there.
You have an appetite fit for a king? Well, why don't we roll into Bristol, PA, to the King George II Inn, the oldest continuously operating inn in America. It sits as the anchor at the end of Main Street in Bristol, PA. We're talking 1600s here, folks. Let's take a look.
If the bar could talk, it would have quite a few stories to tell. King George Inn is America's longest continuously operating inn overlooking the Delaware River. The inn was built in 1681. The inn was originally called the Ferry House, and that was its location here on the edge of the Delaware, so it could cross over into Burlington, New Jersey from Bristol, Pennsylvania. George Washington stayed here at one point, had John Adams and his wife stay here at one point. We've got the Lincoln Room here, we've got the President's Room, and the Radcliffe Room, and those are three private dining areas we have at the inn. The inn has two working fireplaces. They're in the Lincoln Room and the President's Room. We also have two decks looking out over the water, as well as a beautiful tavern. Well, our tavern is named the Lafayette Tavern. The bar has a literal bar taken from a ship. It's called the Lafayette in the 1700s. You can definitely feel the history in the bar. We have a signature drink, which is the Lafayette Lemonade, named after the Lafayette Tavern, of course. The Lafayette Lemonade has citron vodka, it has fresh squeezed lemonade, and a raw sugar rim. The inn offers American continental food. We do tavern fare, we do regular fine dining. So we've got a delicious cheesecake brownie with chocolate sauce and vanilla ice cream and a walnut streusel. We've also got a King's Chop here, which is a 14-ounce French cut pork chop. It's got a apple chutney on it and a cinnamon maple roasted apple with herb compound and mashed potatoes. Also got a burrata cheese with confit tomatoes. It's got homemade pesto, roasted garlic bread, and then a delicious Lafayette lemonade. The inn is the center of town. It's located right by the wharf here in Bristol Borough, and it's at the corner of the two main streets here in town. and has been since 1681. The King George Inn likes to offer a wonderful dining experience overlooking the Delaware River. We've got great servers, we've got great bartenders that can make you a delicious drink, and a beautiful view while you get waited on.
Let's Go wants your photos and videos. Have you recently gone on a trip in or around the Greater Lehigh Valley? Have you found a hidden museum or a new outdoor location to spend the afternoon? Well, Let's Go wants to hear from you. Share your videos or photos, and we may feature them in a future episode. Email them to letsgo@wlvt.org or upload them at wlvt.org/letsgo.
Well, that's it for this episode. Thanks for stopping by. Tune in next Thursday when we'll have more fun and adventure for you right here on Let's Go.
We have a variety of different educational opportunities. We have some baby beavers, some young great horned owls, and some fawns.